Hey kids, welcome back. Inverted Cow here. Just working on a few of the quest items and quest things. Behind me here is the infamous Tinker Steelworks thing. I've just spent the better part of 2 hours yelling and cursing at this pile of junk to try and actually get it to work. I finally got it working, sort of. So I figured I'd give a quick little blurb of how I figured it out. Alright, I'm making the steel for the this last quest. I've got most of it already. Load in your oxidizer, your reducer, and your whatever. Who cares? Whatever they're called, but follow them in the exact recipe. You can't use the aluminum or dust. You have to actually use pulverized aluminum ore, so you gotta smelt it and then pulverize it. Yeah, redstone and charcoal. The thing is, it's supposed to be able to be automated through the use of this so-called scorched duct that goes on the side. The first time through, I loaded this with all the ingredients. I put a hopper on it. I loaded all the ingredients on there, and I walked away. Well, of course, everything sat in here, and nothing functioned. So I had to take this apart, empty it out, and then go through it. Now, there's a selector in here for what port or hole or whatever it goes in. Unfortunately, these have absolutely no meaning whatsoever. Because if you load this full of charcoal, put it on burner, it's glitchy. It's glitchy, glitchy, glitchy. I had 4 stacks of charcoal in there. I had 1 stack of charcoal in here. And all it did, whoops, there we go. All it did was cycle and count through to like 10 pieces of charcoal, and it got up to 3,000 degrees. It didn't burn properly. It didn't do a thing. Stay. So it's not worth the headache. I don't know if it's supposed to be automated or what. Now you need a redstone signal. I just put a lever on the side here. This will cool off now and stop burning. Yeah, my resources are too stretched, too thin to be wasting on stupid things like this. So let's do a quick little 1 FPS. Let's do a quick little look around and see how things are going. I just put a hopper or a chest here so I get my charcoal. And it's full. Oh, I've actually completed a quest. The iceberg quest. This is a good one. This one, I very simply, you set up these quest delivery systems. When you place them down, they're blank like this. When you want to assign it to a quest, you pick a quest. Now, I just completed this iceberg one. I'm working on this crystal clear one. But you pick a quest, so we'll say, for example, this, and then you select task, and then you click that on the book. Now, I'm not going to select Neptune's clouds because I'm not sure how I'm going to harvest those clouds yet. I had this one doing the glacial one. Of course, it's pumping all my ice in there still. It's still sucking it away. It's just, it has no need. So make sure you assign the quest before you actually start pumping items in there. Otherwise, you're just going to lose items. Currently working on the cyclic assembler. I made one of these, and I'm working on making the compressed sand. basically once all of these stacks of sand have hit 64 and then I put a half a stack beside it, I'll have enough compressed sand to complete the quest. And then I compress it one more level up and I'm done. It also means that I'm running sand for the glass quest, which is pumping it into the smeltery and into an oven underground here. Basically as fast as I can produce it. I got two. I took my loop, pulverizer loop, and I took a second pulverizer and I hooked it on there. So now I pulverize the cobble and I'll pump it into gravel. The gravel gets pulverized to sand. Whatever the goes to the yellow slot. Whatever goes into the yellow slot ends up going back into the autonomous activator in the middle of this little cluster of things and gets shaken into its respective sand or dirt or whatever, and I end up with raw materials which go into this chest. Everything goes into this chest and then pumps back into the system. And you're going to see my total limit of expertise on ME. They force you to make ME. I hate ME. I'm sorry, I've attempted a few times to actually start to learn to like it, but every time I try, I find the interface drives me nuts. This has the ability to select and mass produce whatever's in inventory, but it's still a pain in the butt. I made a second smeltery here. Oh, I forgot my casting. I made a second smeltery so I could keep up on my orders. Down here I've got my charcoal production facility. This makes charcoal, which powers these two steam generators and this glass furnace. This is just making vanilla glass. And it's pumping into this crystal clear cask here. Now that's this one here. This has been running for about 2 days solid now, and as you can see, it's not exactly overwhelming on glass. I'm making this sands of time one. That's the sands I showed you upstairs. Working on that. The punch tree get blisters. I've been going. This one, my tree farm's been running non-stop for probably about 3 days that I've been on. I made this simply because I had to. It's probably going to sit in the chest. I'm not even sure about this one. I have to do that. The laser I'm going to have to build and eventually put a power system up that can handle it. Right now I'm running on two magmatic dynamos and two steam dynamos, and they're keeping everything functional. And my lag is getting sick with that. As you can tell, I keep dropping down to one frame per second. Stupid things like that. Of course, the lag always drops every time the trees get harvested. I automated my dirt production, semi-automated, I guess. I collect trees, zombie meat, surplus meat, whatever. I throw it in here. It goes in the barrels. The barrels collects it. Goes into the dirt chest, which pumps back into the system overall. I use the dirt chest because you can't put anything in it besides dirt, so the pipes don't try to insert anything into it. They just take out. And oops, the dirt stack piling up here. Now once this barrel gets full, I'll probably set up a cyclic assembler to do the dirt compression, because there's a thing here for 100 quadruple compressed dirts. Oops. Also, looking at the quest, because this is what I'm basically working on today. Hell's Kitchen. I've done the smooth ice. Of course, as soon as you make the glacial precipitator, you finish this one. Some of these quests are a little bit insane. 10,000 toasts. 10,000 vinegar. You know, same thing. Meatballs and whatnot. Skyblock one here. I have to summon my my angry doll. I love these hints. This is helpful. I have to summon the angry doll and finish this quest. Then I've got this one here where I need to make the redneck cable and redstone energy conduit. There's a couple of machines I need to make to do those, so unfortunately it's more often than not everything is being held up because of the shortage of resources. I've been working on the Thaum lab, but I found that you can't do Thaumcraft research the way you normally can. The Thaumcraft research is done. Normally you throw a piece of paper on the table, you manipulate aspects, and do your research, but you can't put paper on here. I've tried. It won't let me do it. There we go. If you go onto your Thaumcraft book, you actually have to purchase the research as opposed to actually doing the research. Which is really, really, really annoying. But, I mean, Thaumcraft is incredibly annoying as well. And the bees, this is another one. I'm not a big person on the bees. I mean, quite honestly, you can take it out of the game and I wouldn't miss it one bit. And it's actually fairly involved. But if you scroll down to the very, very bottom and open up number 9, you need 100,000 drones. So unfortunately, to do this one, you're going to need a lot of bees. I have not found any use at this time for the mariculture fish. These things, so I'm just putting it in a filing cabinet because it's just something that's wasting my time and energy. So yeah, now we're just kind of at holding mode now. It's just build and fill quests. So that's how it goes. Oh yeah, my spiffy gold armor or diamond armor that I'm wearing. This is all enchanted armor. I got it from one of my quests that I actually completed in the hoarding series here, actually. When I did the blacksmith blocks, I picked one of the bags, and it was in my bag. It's kind of nice. So the quests are worth it to do it, but yeah, it's a lot of research and a lot of time spent just waiting for machines to get processed. So that's it for another day from Inverted Cow, and I'll talk to y'all later, kids.